The Ministry of Environment, together with the National Environment Management Authority and the Environment Police, have today relaunched operations against developments in wetlands. Dozens of residential houses were demolished and crops destroyed during the operation.
For us, you see now, how are we going to start now?
Due to the operation, hundreds of residents in Butabika Hospital Village were left homeless. However, Simon Peter Okoshi, the commandant of the Environmental Police, says that encroachers had been earlier warned to vacate the wetlands, but in vain.
If these people wanted to break the house, they could come and first warn us that, you people, these days we are coming, you people get prepared, pick your things slowly, slowly, you take away, you get where to stay. Now they have just come abruptly without informing us. Now they are saying they have been warning us. When have they been warning us?
We are trying to make this place look as it was before it was encroached upon. And our role here is very simple. The main job is being done by technical staff from the Ministry of Water and Environment, led by a technical officer. For us as police, we are providing security.
Okoshi further reveals that they are to continue with similar operations in different parts of the country as a way of protecting the environment.
We have officers from the State House Anti-Corruption Unit, headed by Brigadier General Henry Isoke, attached to us to ensure that we do a professional job. And their work is also to make observations on where mistakes could have been made.
As the operation continued, some of the affected residents mobilized and started protesting. This had even blocked the road, but were immediately dispersed by the police.
They just called my friend. So now my friend is the one who told me. So now I just come back right now. I find everything is down. Where are we going to start?
George Wamonga, the senior wetlands officer from the Ministry of Water and Environment, said that no one will be compensated for their demolished buildings since it is illegal to carry out any activity in a wetland.
Them compensate us, we go in peace.
That we have been coming here asking them to peacefully and voluntary relief, but they have never left until today, that when we are pushing them out. They think it is abandoned land, but land belongs to government. And the government has protected it, knowing its purpose. But for them, they think it is free land. They come and just occupy.
According to NEMA, the wetland coverage reduced from 15.5% in 1994 to about 13% today. Out of the remaining wetlands in Uganda, only 8.9% are still intact, while 4.1% are degraded.
Government protects them for the good of the people. So when they come here, there is no compensation, but we are sending them out voluntarily or forcefully. Let them go. They are not supposed to be in the wetland.
Butabika Wetland is part of Lake Victoria's catchment area. However, in the past 1.5 decades, the wetland has been encroached on. Formerly occupied by papyrus and other wetland vegetation, this swamp is, however, currently filled with houses and other human activities.
We estimate that around 5,000 people will be affected. Others who are within the areas which are concentrated, like at the railway crossing, that is where we know as Chinawataka, but it's Katogo.